on infection control. The purpose of the infection control program is to prevent the spread of infectious processes within the facility, between ourselves and the individuals. Who thinks the number one thing is to prevent the spread of infection? Wash your hands. Good hand washing, right? Not just a quick rinse under the faucet. Talk of good hand washing, working up the lather, getting it between the webs of your fingers and up and over your ribs, and rinsing in a downward fashion. The key thing about washing your hands here on the faucet is you can never touch the faucet after you've washed your hands. You're supposed to utilize the paper towel that you pull to dry your hands or pull a fresh towel and dry your hands that way. It's a recommendation by the CDC. It's our policy. And when state comes in every year, they will look for that, okay? So make that a habit that you utilize that paper towel every time you wash your hands. Personal protective equipment. We have a variety of it here at Wendell Foster. The one thing that you utilize the most is your gloves on and off all day. Do you have to wash your hands after you remove your gloves?
Yes.
Do you have to put on fresh gloves when you move from individual to individual?
Yes.
Absolutely. All right, you also have masks and gowns and other personal protective equipment that we utilize mainly when we have someone in isolation. But you are welcome to use them whenever you feel that the need arises. When should you use your personal protective equipment? Basically, any time there's a possibility that you're going to be exposed to body fluids. Okay? Just that simple. Whatever that means. Whether you're assisting someone with a meal or assisting them to the restroom, anytime there's the potential to be exposed to someone's body fluids, an exposure incident, that's any time that you've been exposed to someone's body fluid. Whatever means possible that could be. For nurses, it's usually a needle stick. In the healthcare setting, it's body fluid, blood. That could be from someone that bit you, or you're assisting someone with their meal, the restroom, whatever, and you've got a cut on your hand. Somehow their body fluid, urine, saliva, blood, whatever gets into that cut, it can be that simple. This is not something you keep secret. If you're exposed to someone's body fluids, please, please contact the nurse in your cottage and she'll help you take care of that, okay? You don't get in trouble for that. You just want to make sure that you're kept healthy. That's it, bottom line. We're going to talk a little bit about hepatitis B. Hepatitis B is a blood-borne pathogen. This organ is important to destroy your liver. Your liver is an essential organ for life. You've got to have one, right? Or part of one. It does a lot of things for you. It filters all your blood. It produces vitamins. And it also produces clotting factors so that you can cut yourself open to death. So it's an important organ. Signs and symptoms of hepatitis are up here on the board. Many vary, and all of them quite ugly. So how do you get hepatitis? In the healthcare settings, the most common way are blood, mucous membrane contact, body fluid. That's why your PPEs are so important. Is that the only place you can get hepatitis? Those of you who've got kids in the audience, what was the first vaccine your baby got before it left the hospital? Hepatitis, right? That's how important it is. You can also be transmitted with hepatitis by having unprotected sex, sharing drug needles, tattoos, piercings. Those are also good ways to get hepatitis. So how can you prevent getting hepatitis? Don't do any of those things I just said. In the healthcare setting, utilize your personal protective equipment, out of town. If you're getting a tattoo, make sure they open that sterile package in front of you. Okay, if someone comes out to do your tattoo and the packages are already open, that's not the place for you to get a tattoo, okay? Or if you're seeing, they should be proud to open that sterile package in front of you. HIV virus, this is also a blood-borne pathogen. This organism works to destroy your immune system so you can't fight off an infection, such as cough, cold, pneumonia, staph infection. Everybody understand that? The last phase is when people have AIDS, I'm sure you've heard that terminology. This is the point where you get to usually where there's no return, you've got no immune system. Thankfully, in the United States, most people don't get here anymore. People are living long, healthy lives being HIV positive. It's not the initial death sentence it was back in the late 80s, early 90s. Physicians have come up with cocktails of drugs that keep it at bay and even make it undetectable in the bloodstream of those that were previously known to be HIV positive. Does that mean they're cured? You can't detect it? No. You still have no signs and symptoms and pass that on to others. So how do you get HIV? Exactly the same way as hepatitis. So if you're at risk for one, you're at risk for the other. In the healthcare setting, needle sticks, bloods, body fluids, out in town, unprotected sex, sharing drug needles, tattoos, piercings, less likely that it could still happen. Especially if you use a needle on someone else, and I have had seen that happen. Last thing I'm going to talk about is the flu. It's flu season. I have ordered the flu vaccine. It should be arriving at any time. Next month, I will be doing a couple of days where we'll be giving the flu vaccine. I highly encourage you to get it. Over 36,000 people every year die of flu. It doesn't go away. It's awful. You cannot get the flu from the flu vaccine. Okay, it's a dead virus. Yes, if you get sick after you got the flu vaccine, that's just coincidence. Okay? And most people, when they feel kind of funny after getting the flu vaccine, it's usually not the flu. If you've ever had the flu, you will never forget it. It's very debilitating. You can't even lift your head off the pillow for a couple of days. It's horrible. Okay? So I highly encourage you to get it. Does anybody have any questions? Is all your test questions answered?
Did she wash her hands? Wash your hands?